There are all kinds of procedurally generated games out there, and I just got done playing a new police shooter one called Rico on PS4. But is this group of buddy cops truly brilliant, or should Rico be recalled? Rico is a first-person shooter. The cases that you're doing are procedurally generated, so no two of them are the same. The game can be played either single player or co-op, and the best experience is going to be in that co-op scenario, both locally and online play is available. The game features four playable characters that you can choose from. You'll level up and gain new traits that you'll be able to add to your characters as you progress through your cases, as well as the cases can be played on one of three different difficulties. There's also the daily case thrown in so that you also have incentive to play the game every day if you really want to. Basically, each case, your goal is to take down a kingpin, but to get to him, you're going to have to go through a lot of other missions to eventually get to that point. The problem with the game, though, starts to mount pretty quickly, as the types of missions you're doing are almost identical to one another, even if the things are procedurally generated. There's a small handful of settings that you'll get to do, like a bank, office building, apartment building, warehouse, but you'll be seeing the same types of setups over and over again. The same goes for the enemies. There's a small handful of types of enemies that you'll see, and you'll be seeing them over and over and hearing them over and over, as there's only a couple of sound effects, seemingly, for the characters in the game. This is made more apparent by the fact there's no music in the levels and very little other ambient noise, so you just hear these grunts and screams of the enemies consistently. Most of the time in the missions, your goal is to collect evidence inside the buildings. There's also other objectives like wiping out all the rooms, completing a certain number of headshots, or defusing bombs if you run across them. You gotta be careful with the bombs though. If you don't defuse them, once you've located them within a certain time, they will blow up and you will die and fail the mission. And doing so, or just having all your health drained, you're starting a case over from the very beginning. Thankfully, you can save temp progress, and if the game crashes, for example, and it probably will, you thankfully only end up failing the mission you were on and can continue doing the case. You only completely wipe out if your character ends up dying. One key thing to know is you can exit missions mid-mission, so if you're really low on health and you know you can't finish it, you can exit, and while you'll fail that particular mission, you won't completely have to start the case over. You just select another point on the roadmap to getting to that final boss. The controls and overall gameplay, though, in Rico is kind of bland and clunky at its best. It's one of those games that I have more fun goofing off and being stupid with it, especially with the slide mechanic. You can slide everywhere, you can move quickly through the levels, and even slide through enemies. You can line multiple up and bowl them over like bowling pins, and they're instantly dead from this. You also have a baton that can instantly kill enemies when you end up striking with them. Because rooms are so small a lot of the times, doing the slide or using the baton is actually more efficient than using the handgun at least. The shotgun is a bit more efficient as far as gunplay is concerned. Guns though don't carry over between runs, so if you end up dying, guns are all reset back to the basic. The only thing that carries over is the traits that you unlock via leveling up. From the technical side of things, like I said, there was crashing, which is probably the biggest problem with the game. There was a few other little issues here and there, and overall clunkiness of the controls. Rico is available for $19.99 on PlayStation 4, Xbox One, Nintendo Switch, and PC. There's also a physical version for the Nintendo Switch for $29.99. It does feature a platinum trophy on the PlayStation 4. Overall, Rico is just okay at its best. I did have some fun with it, but that was mostly due to playing with a friend. Bowling over the enemies using the slide and just goofing off with them was fun, and I'm sure if you have a friend to join you, it can also be enjoyable. But the overall package of Rico, and at the price, it just really isn't that easy to recommend. With everything said, I'm going to be giving Rico a 4 out of 10. That's going to wrap up this review, though. I'd like to thank you for watching, and of course, I hope you enjoyed.